Do I have everybody's attention now? I feel a little bit of recapping is in order. If you didn't see the show last week, and I can't blame you, I didn't watch either because I wasn't on. I was suspended by Vincent K. McMahon. I was suspended because the week prior to that, I got into a little bit of trouble because of some things that I said. I didn't get in trouble because I announced that July 17th, my contract with World Wrestling Entertainment ends. I didn't just get in trouble because I said not only am I going to defeat John Cena this Sunday at the Money in the Bank pay-per-view, but that I was going to leave with the oh-so-precious WWE title, rendering all future champions completely irrelevant. I didn't just get in trouble because of this little nugget. I mentioned when Vince McMahon finally dies that the company will fall into the hands of his idiotic daughter and his son-in-law, who I believe I referred to as a doofus. I got in trouble basically because I have the balls to say things that nobody else has the balls to say. Things like this company, inside and outside the ring, are filled with a parade of shameless ass kissers. But never fear, tonight, not only am I reinstated, not only is my championship match with John Cena back on,
I brought backup just in case they cut my microphone off.
So a lot of you are probably wondering exactly why I'm holding a live microphone right now. I'll explain it to you. Vince McMahon desperately wants to sign me to a very long-term, very lucrative contract with World Wrestling Entertainment. It's funny to me that Vince is bending over backwards to give me everything I've ever wanted. And the reason that's funny is because all I've ever really wanted is this little microphone. See, this is power. This voice, this is power. In anybody else's hands, this is a microphone. In my hands, it's a pipe bomb, as I showed 2 weeks ago. So Vince McMahon finally sees me for what I am, and that is the hottest property in this industry today. He finally sees that way because I did something that he and his endless empty suits could not do. I made WWE socially relevant. And I'm not talking about you people, because you don't really count. I'm talking about the real world. See, in the real world, the WWE has always gotten a mention or two for two reasons. The first one being that CM Punk is speaking his mind. The second one is because somebody died. It's true. But now the WWE, because of me, is all over YouTube. I am a YouTube sensation. ESPN is falling all over themselves to try to get me on their radio shows, to try to get me on their TV shows. Jimmy Kimmel's people are ringing my phone off the hook. They want to know exactly what I have to say. They're begging for my story. And I find it funny that I have one foot out the door and Vince McMahon finally wants to give me everything I want. Well, 5 years ago, Vince McMahon treated me this nice, I wouldn't have 5 years of pent-up ammunition to unload on him. I wouldn't have so much to say. I know Vince McMahon, and I know how he does business, and he's going to come here and he's going to expect me to sit down in his office and have a nice little man-on-man conversation about a contract. But I also know he likes to do things that have never been done before, so I say tonight, Vince McMahon, we have the first ever live contract negotiation in the ring. And who knows, maybe I'll sign, maybe I won't. Maybe Vince McMahon will have to join something that I like to call the CM Punk Kiss My Ass Club.